This video is sponsored by History Kit. So we all know that Neanderthals and modern humans are closest related to each other when it comes to different species in the Homo genus. Of course, this is not talking about the subspecies, but I bet you understood that already. But even though they are much alike as species, there are some key differences. Many of these differences are subjects that I have covered in previous videos, but today we're going to focus on the differences when it comes to the brain development of both these species. My name is Kaylee, and like I said, in this video we're going to look at how Neanderthal brains develop in comparison to the brain development of us modern humans, and where and how they differ. So the first thing that I would like to mention is the fact that us modern humans, or, you know, otherwise known as Homo sapiens sapiens, and Neanderthals, again otherwise known as Homo neanderthalensis, have the same common ancestor. I do think that the majority of the people watching me and watching this video already knew this, of course. This was the reason as to why we as two different species were able to, you know, interbreed. And this is evident in the fact that we as modern humans can carry up to 4% of Neanderthal DNA within our genomes. This is something I've mentioned more than once at least. So comparing us modern humans with the Neanderthals can provide us some incredible insights that are simply fascinating, and it shows how we as a species are unique to the previous human species that lived before us. And we, Homo sapiens sapiens, yes, two sapiens, or, you know, modern humans, if you will, are unique when it comes to the development of our brain. So mammals have a unique and crucial component to the brain. This is the neocortex, which is the largest part of the outer layer of the brain. This is not found in other animals. It's unique to mammals. So during the evolution of the different human species in the Homo genus, the neocortex seemed to have expanded drastically. So this expansion resulted in Neanderthals and us modern humans having similar brain sizes. So this expansion resulted in Neanderthals and us modern humans having similar brain sizes. Although until recently it wasn't known how much the brains of these two species may have differed in function and development. So I am happy to tell you that the Max Planck Institute in Dresden and in Leipzig in Germany did a study into this, and this can actually help us learn more about our closest cousins in terms of human evolution. But speaking about learning, our sponsor today, History Hit, is perfect for learning more. Immerse yourself into new historical topics through more than 1,000 podcast episodes and 5,000 history-related travel articles using History Hit. It brings you the stories that shape the world through its award-winning podcast network and online history channel, with new content added weekly. Explore over 50 new podcast episodes and two latest exclusive programs that they launch every week with expert-led historians such as Dan Snow, Suzanne Lipscomb, Matt Lewis, Tristan Hughes, and more. Whilst Dan Snow's History Hit continues to be the world's leading history podcast, we now have four more podcasts covering the ancients, warfare, gone medieval, and not just the Tudors, hosted by Susanna Lipscomb. Sign up for this astounding podcast network as it exemplifies the great traditions of documentary filmmaking. The quest to capture unique imagery, venture into the unknown, and tell compelling stories based on the insights of historians, scientists, and explorers. So, click the link in the description to start your journey today and get 50% off of your next 3 months using code HISTORYWITHKAYLEE at checkout. And now that I've told you about today's sponsor, it is time to look into how differently the Neanderthal brains developed when compared to the development of the brains of us modern humans. So they discovered that neural stem cells, these are the cells which the neurons in the developing neocortex derive, spend more time in preparation of their chromosomes for division in us modern humans than they did in the Neanderthals. This more time in preparation actually leads to less errors when the chromosomes are distributed to the daughter cells in us modern humans than it does in Neanderthals or even in chimpanzees. This could actually have certain consequences in not only how the brain develops over time, but also how the brain functions. The study showed cellular differences in the development of the brains between Neanderthals and us modern humans. So, what are these cellular differences, I hear you think? So let's get into that. Well, after our ancestors split from the genetic line that led to Neanderthals and Denisovans, approximately 100 amino acids, which are the building blocks of proteins in cells and tissues, changed in us modern humans. And this eventually spread to almost all modern humans. This has to do with the fact that all modern humans living today can be traced back to three African tribes 50,000 years ago. Although the biological significance is largely unknown when it comes to these changes. But what we do know is that six of the 100 amino acids changes happened in three proteins that actually play key roles in the distribution of chromosomes, which we all know are the carriers of genetic information to the two daughter cells during the cell division. So to try and investigate the significance of these six amino acid changes for the development of the neocortex, the researchers introduced these six variants found in us modern humans in mice. This was actually done because apparently, this is something I didn't know but I learned while researching, apparently mice are identical to Neanderthals when it comes to these six amino acid positions. And therefore, these changes made them the perfect model for the developing modern human brain. Three of these modern human amino acids in two of the proteins cause a longer metaphase. This is actually the phase where the chromosomes are being prepared for cell division. And this longer metaphase is what leads to fewer errors when the chromosomes are being distributed to the daughter cells of the neural stem cells, just like in modern humans. They saw the same in the mice. They then tried to see if the Neanderthal amino acids had the opposite effect. They did this by the use of human brain organoids, which are miniature organ-like structures that have been grown from human stem cells. These brain organoids are situated in cell culture dishes in the lab and they mimic aspects of early human brain development. The researchers then introduced the ancestral Neanderthal amino acids to these brain organoids to see how they would develop. And what they saw happen was that the metaphase was shorter and there were more chromosome errors during the distribution, just as they suspected, and now it was confirmed. Three of the six amino acid changes in two of the three proteins are responsible for fewer mistakes during the chromosome distribution in us modern humans, compared to the Neanderthal and chimpanzees models. You may ask yourself, why chimpanzees? Well, chimpanzees are our closest living relatives at this point in time, as both of our species are hominini. Therefore, it is smart to research the differences between us and them as well. Of course, as you can imagine, having fewer mistakes is very important, as mistakes in the number of chromosomes and divisions of cells can lead to disorders or diseases like cancer. This research actually suggests that the function of the brain of Neanderthal might have been more affected by these chromosome errors than us modern humans. And I think that's very important. But of course, as you can imagine, more research and future studies are needed to investigate if the decreased error rates in us modern humans affect traits that are related to the functions of the brain. But studies like these do show that even though the species of Neanderthals and us modern humans are incredibly similar, there are some key differences, and these differences would have had quite the impact, if I'm going to be honest. I feel like they would have made quite the impact. This may actually even have an effect on why Neanderthals no longer roam the Earth, why we as a species survived and even thrived, and they as a species disappeared. And yes, they were most likely assimilated in our species and didn't just one day go extinct. That doesn't make any sense. They didn't disappear out of the blue, but they no longer inhabit the planet, and the way their brains functioned might have actually been one of the reasons for their eventual demise. It's quite plausible, to be honest. So I'm excited to see what future studies might tell us, but until then we will have to make do with whatever information comes to light, and we need to try and understand the implications that it may have on our understanding of our sister species, the Neanderthals, our cousins. But before I go, I would like to remind you to click the link in the description to start your History Hit journey today and get yourself 50% off of your next 3 months using code History with Kaylee at checkout. And with that said, if you enjoyed watching, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, and click that bell icon if you want to be notified whenever I upload. If you haven't seen my previous videos yet, then click the card in the upper right corner, or click a link in the description down below, or click a video in the end card. It's set to best for viewer, so YouTube caters to you. I would also like to say a massive thank you to all my patrons and all my channel members. I am eternally grateful for all your support, and if you like my work and you want to support me, then consider becoming a patron or a channel member. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye!